Hello everyone, welcome back to another edition of West Ham Fan TV's post-match pint, the only West Ham United post-match forward show
on the internet.
Miss that, we've missed that.
the smallest ever post-match pint panel we've had here. I mean,
Ryan and Scott are up there still.
Yeah, they're still up there, and Dan's had trouble getting here with some adverse weather conditions, but we've just watched the game against Huddersfield. It was West Ham 1, Huddersfield 1. Let's take us through the starting lineup. Do you know it?
Yeah,
go on.
Yeah. Let's get the old memory working. Right, so Fabianski, obviously. Yeah. Creswell left. Babwen and Diop in the middle. Zabaleta right. Snodgrass on the left.
Sorry, I have to fiddle around with this because it's charging my phone.
Obiang in the middle.
With Snobby?
Right, Snodgrass was on
Do
the
you know
left.
What? It was unchanged from last week.
Yeah.
It was unchanged from last week. Creswell played as well. We're gonna have a little discussion here, Gray, between ourselves. So you might get a word in edgeways this way, mate.
Never know.
It's a tough one this one, because it wasn't a vintage performance. In fact, it was a pretty poor performance. It was open for both teams.
I'll tell you what, it was a decent game.
But I think we've done all right to get a point there, to be honest, because I couldn't see it.
I mean, after the conceding the early goal, which we'll come to in a minute, you know, the warning signs were there before that.
Yeah.
You know, Fabianski made a really good
save. Good save, yeah. World class save, yeah.
Strong hand, pushed it away. But saying that, first couple of minutes, we could have been one up. You know, I only got one on one.
It was a difficult angle, weren't it? I think
it's a good save from the keeper.
It was a good save, but he needs to go with a chip there. I think he needs to try and go over the keeper, you know?
Yeah, or Anderson was square. He was bombing up there.
But
as well.
Arnie in that position, mate, he's always going to shoot, isn't he?
You put your ass on him, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
To score.
You'd put your ass on him to score. That's the key thing, but the keeper made the save. And within about a minute, we found ourselves one behind. It was a decent strike.
Yeah, to be honest, I think Fabianski was made to take a little bit by surprise, but I don't think he was expecting that to come through.
No.
It came through legs. I don't think it
wasn't a vintage strike. It was a decent strike, but it was very low. If Fabianski would have been a bit more sighted, he would have saved it.
But
when I looked at the replay behind the goal, it came quick through some legs. Mm. Should it get through the legs?
As a defender myself, or having been a defender, you're always disappointed if you get one through your legs.
Yeah.
I think initially they're trying to I think it took Fabianski by surprise a little bit, because his reaction once it came through, it was a little slow getting down, but I mean, you couldn't really blame him for it. You know, he was unsighted the initial shot, you know, but then, you know, that early on, the crowd are up. I mean, I've been up there last year, so it's a loud ground.
I don't know what the weather was like. What did the weather look like to you?
Yeah, it looks alright, not so bad. Better than down here anyway.
Yeah, it's fucking pissing down here. But because I was going to blame adverse weather conditions, but you can't really blame the weather.
Do you know what I think? I just feel did their own work.
Yeah, I was just about to say that when you looked at the way we started with Dean Garner, I thought, you know, the first 5 minutes he was doing well, Dean Garner. I think, was it the one where he sort of flicked it over that geezer and skinned him?
Yeah.
What set up the Arnie chance? Was that one? Yeah, I think that was that one. I thought his kid's going to have a brilliant game. But from there, they didn't let him have any breathing space.
Have a pairing up on him at times.
Trailing up on him, yeah.
Which should leave, in theory, should leave space elsewhere on the pitch to sort of open them up a bit. But I say, I thought Huddersfield were really good with their closing down. Didn't really allow us to settle into any sort of rhythm.
The thing I would say about the West Ham today, though, mate, is it's still a work in progress, isn't it? Do you know what I mean?
Like,
we ain't earned the right yet to go to Huddersfield and beat them quite comfortably. a point away from home in the Premier League, any point away from home in the Premier League is a good point, you know what I mean?
The thing is, I know Huddersfield's problem has been scoring goals, especially at home, but they're a tough team to break down.
Yeah.
Once they
got that goal, they was always going to be, you know, resilient. And
yeah, backs were up, the crowd were behind them.
Plus, they'd won last week.
Got
their first win, and that always breeds confidence, doesn't it? And it's just their fucking luck, isn't it? That,
yeah, I mean, look at when we got our first win, we went on a little run.
Yeah, three games, it does breed confidence, like a win and all that sort of stuff. But it's just our luck that when, you know, they've been down and out more or less, them and Newcastle.
Yeah, it was another win today.
When we're coming up to play in Huddersfield, they get another win. They get, well, a win. And then they come into us confident, and we're just about to play Newcastle. We're not too far away from Newcastle.
Yeah, after the international break.
And then, and then they've got two wins on a spin now. Mm. You know what I mean? And they haven't won all year.
Yeah, at a ground we don't traditionally do well at. And that big walk upstairs,
am I? I've just heard that I might have to go up there now, which I'm not too happy about.
We was on the back foot a little bit. Laid at the post, which I think was a cross initially.
I'll tell you what, to be honest with you, when I watch it, how that ain't gone in, I don't know, because that has literally hit the post, gone along the line behind Fabianski, and then somehow swerved itself out.
Yeah,
I don't know how it come out.
Yeah, well, initially I was waiting for the old got it this season,
goal line technology.
Yeah, I was waiting for the old ref to get the buzz on.
All in all, mate, I thought we was very poor. I thought Anderson was very poor again.
Was that on Colding? I mean, like last week, he showed what he did.
Yeah, it's mustard last week, you know what I mean? And he's got two goals, but, well, we'll talk about it in a second, but, you know, he's one of them players, isn't he? To be honest with you, when the half-time whistle came and he took Dean Garner off, I know Dean Garner was a bit more out of the game, and he brought Chicharito on, I thought Anderson might have been the one to go, because I thought he was that bad, you know what I mean? But someone did make a point to me as we were watching it today, saying to me, like, you know, is it because we judge him too harsh because of his price tag? You know, you expect a bit too much out of him he hadn't long to settle in, and it's a tough league to settle into. It's so different from the Serie A that, you know, it's going to take, sometimes it takes, Zaza is a prime example, never settled in.
Never settled.
But he got a goal. And I'll tell you what, well, beginning of the second half, we started with a Chicharito chance, which, I'll be honest with you, I thought he should have done better.
Yeah, I mean, he was pinging about a bit initially.
Yeah, but once he got that chance, the keeper was down, there was no keeper there. I thought he should have done a bit better with that header, to be honest with you.
The thing is, he had two defenders coming back on the line. He had to sort of get it up
and over, yeah.
Yeah, but just wouldn't quite come down.
And we had one cleared off the line from the corner. Second half was a lot better. A lot of improvement in the West Ham team. We was passing the ball a lot better. We're struggling a bit in midfield, but with the injuries and suspensions we've got, we're always going to.
Say Noble should be back. For the Newcastle game,
yeah. But he was sitting in the crowd. So probably could have done with him a bit of notes today. Yeah. But it was a lot better second half. And you know, we had one cleared off the line. Huddersfield had a couple of chances as well.
With that last ditch tackle,
could have made it 2-0. They had their chances as well. But then when the chance fell to Anderson, a finish that is.
Yeah, Pinging about.
He picked up the ball, Bosch, straight in the top corner.
Yeah.
Now that is a finish.
Yeah.
That is a world class finish. I suppose that's what £40 million gets you.
Yeah.
Forget what
went on before that. Forget that.
And I'll be honest with you, mate. From there, I thought we was going to go on to win the game.
We certainly had our tails up after that.
What do you think about? I mean, what were you in now? 12 games? 13 games? About a third way through the season. Obviously not in a position we'd want to be in.
No.
But what have you thought of Pellegrini's reign so far?
We spent a fair bit of money at the start of the season, but we bought 9 players, they've got a bed in. We're a work in progress.
I think we're playing a lot nicer football.
Yeah, we're a lot better to watch. I'm not too worried about league position at the minute. We're heading in the right direction.
We had a lot of tough games as
well.
Yeah,
we had some tough games.
We've had the top five of the top six, and I think we've got Man City.
Yeah, soon.
Soon. Yeah. Yeah,
that'll be the acid test, I think. Well, know, especially by
the thing is, up to the new year, it's only Man City, and the rest of the teams that we've got are in and about us. Mm. So there's a lot of opportunity to pick up points here. You know what I mean? Yeah. So
I mean,
do you know what? I think he's done all right.
Yeah, I think he's got us playing.
He's struggling like every other manager in the last couple of years with injuries.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like Wilshere, obviously, not on the cards. He was going to get injured. Carroll, I heard he was back, but he ain't back. I don't know what I don't know where he is, or you know how far he is in his rehabilitation. I've obviously got, you know, the one for me, mate, is Lanzini. I think once Lanzini comes back, I think he makes things tick. You know what I mean? Yeah, I think he gets
creative.
Yeah,
spark.
Yeah, I do. I think he gets things ticking, and I think like when you've got him, Wilshere and Noble or Obiang or Rice especially. Mm. In that midfield that can make them things tick, and he can, you know, he's the real creative spark that we lay play. I think it's going to be a different story. It's just really unfortunate for Pellegrini that we, you know, the thing is, I moan now about oh, we didn't sign enough and all that, but you can't really knock them for not signing them.
No.
They've signed them. Sanchez, we signed Sanchez because we needed defensive cover. All right, he weren't a big name or you know, big signing that. You know, you'd want, but he was playing all right. He wasn't playing too badly, and he's gone out. He's out for the season now. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We've had Yarmolenko,
who looked like he was shaping up to be
a
cult hero.
He was shaping up to be a thingy. He's gone down. He's out for the season now. You've got Carroll still on long term. Reed still on long term. Lanzini still on long term. Wilshere, fuck knows when he's going to be back. He's might as well flip a coin every week to see whether he's going to be back or not. So is that to deal with the injuries that the other West Ham managers have had to deal with?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
But no, like I say, we're heading in the right direction, aren't we?
I think so. I'm not too worried. It's one of them things where, like, you know, Pep at City didn't build it all in a day, did he? Look at them now.
I mean,
you know
their first season didn't win anything.
That's what I'm saying. I'm not comparing us to Man City.
They won the League Cup, didn't they?
Yeah, I think they did.
Yeah, didn't win the. You know, he was brought in to win the league. But the thing for bringing Pep in is the Champions League, and that's what they're building for. But, you know, Rome wasn't built in a day.
Yeah, I think it's a work in progress. I think people should need to be a bit patient. We haven't.
Yeah, yeah.
We have not earned the right to go to Huddersfield and just breeze over them yet. You know, it's still a work in progress. We need to be patient. And I know it's frustrating. Like, we haven't had a back-to-back win in 2 years, but that ain't Pellegrini's fault, you know, because the past 2 years has been the Moyes and Bilic era, you know what I mean? So that's not really down to him. You know, he's building a team that he wants. I've heard that there might be a bit of bunts there in January, even. You know what I mean? You know, so start to get. I think the thing he needs to do, Gray, is I think he needs to get rid of a bit of dead wood. You know, there's a lot of dead wood at our club, and you know, it needs clearing and refreshing, to be honest.
Yeah, which he may do at the end of the season.
I don't think he wanted to do that this year because of all the new players. And you know, you could be really in trouble there.
Yeah. So probably the end of the season.
Who goes for you?
It's a tough one.
I'll be honest with you. First person I'd be looking to replace is the left back, Cresswell. I think he goes for me.
I'd say his first season for us, he was fantastic, wasn't he? And then he had a second season was a bit.
The second season was good because that was the bowling season. The first season was his under Allardyce, which I thought he was good. It was the injury after the second season that sort of like hampered him. Do you know what? Chris is a good, honest player, I'm sure of it, but like, I don't know, just. Look, a couple of years ago, Man City were looking at him for £25 million, and I would have said we was mad to let him go. So, like, it just shows you how things can go in football. But
I mean, the thing is, as well, you think like Carroll, we've hardly seen him for
5 years, whatever it is.
Yeah, for like the last two seasons, he's hardly featured, has he? And he's on big money as well. But then the thing is, who's going to buy him?
Look, he's going to be it for another couple of years. We all thought, like, at the beginning of the season, nobody knew about this, but we all thought he was going to be off in the summer, contracts up and all that. But he's got an extension for 2 years, so he's going to have another two. You're going to have another 2 years of him. So you've got another 2 years of paying 100 grand a week or 80 grand a week or whatever it is, where he's going to barely be there. But the thing about him is when he comes back, he's good. You know what I mean? And
but it's that thing, like, you might get 4 or 5 games,
yeah,
and then he's injured again. And hey, look, no footballer enjoys being injured.
You know, I'm sure.
It's not his fault, but in this day and age, the money you pay. I don't know.
Antonio?
Maybe. I mean, I don't think he was too bad when he came on today.
Yeah. Put himself about a little bit.
They may look to cash in on him. You know, I mean, in England squads.
Yeah.
But I don't know, since he got into the England squad, his form seems to have dipped a bit. I don't know. The thing is, we're not blessed with the size squads at your Man City's, your Liverpool's, your Arsenal. You know, we need every player. So, you don't want to be sort of shipping people out,
yeah,
willy nilly. You know, if you're going to,
who's he? You know, how much are you going to cost us?
If you're going to get rid of people, we need to make sure that we've got the players lined up to, you don't want to just get rid of people before you've got the players lined up to come in.
Yeah. Definitely, mate. Do you know what? It is what it is today. I don't think there's much you can really say.
Yeah, look, like
saying, international break now. It means we ain't lost in two. Good win last week.
Yeah. Look, point away from home in the Premier League.
And who have we got when you come back?
Newcastle.
Is it?
Yeah, I think, it's Newcastle.
We've got Man City before that. What's the date? No, it's not, honestly. Newcastle's in December. I'm sure of it.
Do you want me to have a look?
Yeah, please.
Let me have a look.
No, it's alright, don't worry about it. Fuck it.
I'm sure it was Newcastle. That might be Man City, then Newcastle.
Yeah, which Newcastle game.
Again, we never do well up there.
Yeah, it's a bit of a tough one. I'll take a draw there now, but Man City game, you might as well write it off. They smack 5-6 every week now, Gray.
Yeah, well, they've got a big game tomorrow, haven't they? So.
Yeah, but they've got another 2 weeks to prepare.
We could do with that one coming up straight after. But look, you've got to believe you can go into these games winning. What's the point of turning up?
Yeah.
You know, you've got to believe that you can win. I know, like Bardi, the other year when we won up there, when we had that our last bowling season, over 3 games we played them. I think it was something like 12 goals they scored.
What was the League Cup? 9-0, wasn't it, on aggregate? 9-1?
Yeah, it was a few. Yeah, 9-0 on aggregate.
I don't know, if you get anything now, you never know. It just depends what West Ham turn up on a day and what Man City turn up on a day.
Yeah.
No, don't get me wrong, they don't have many off days now.
Nah,
you know what I mean, right? And
even on their off days,
but Pellegrini and all that sort of connection—you never know.
But you've got to go in believing that you can get something. Otherwise, there's no point turning up.
Yeah.
So the optimist in us will be, we can go in. You know, we can nick something. But
I don't know.
It could be a long after.
I don't. You're trying to convince yourself. I mean. That's your problem.
Yeah.
man. But that's things anyway. I've been away. That's things.
Yeah, mate. Yeah. Good holiday.
Oh, lovely. Yeah. Do you know when I watched Hashtag? I see someone tweet us, what the fuck's this? Because I went and watched, obviously, you know that we're involved in a Sunday league team. We run a Sunday league team called the Thames Ironworks. Ethan Payne, who you know as Bazinga, runs a team called the AFC Sidemates, which is it's made up of a good few of our players from Sunday League. Ethan plays for us, and a lot of the boys played for us. They went and played XOFC today, the True Geordies team, and I went and had a look, and I'll tell you what, mate,
you said they played really well.
They did play really well. I'm not going to spoil the result, but
a screamer was scored.
A screamer was scored, yeah, and it weren't the True Geordie doing it, that's for sure. I went and watched them today, and then afterwards they invited me to watch Hashtag. So what I was doing if many of you was thinking, oh God, he's at the Ashtag game and he's not watching the West Ham game. Well, it was obviously because I've been on holiday. We had arranged trip. We arranged trips in the fact that, like, sometimes me and Ryan go up there. Well, most of the time me and Ryan go up there. Scott might go in my place sometimes, or someone might go in Scott's Ryan's place occasionally. Yeah. So because I was on holiday this week, I've had a few bits to tie up. I did that, and Scott, he went up to watch the Huddersfield game with Ryan. And after the XO game, I was quite contemplating going back home and watching it on the telly. Yeah. But the boys, nice enough of them, they invited me to go and watch the Ashtag game, which was like literally a 5-minute walk up the road. I see a chicken shop in a petrol garage.
A chicken shop
in a petrol garage.
Getting me?
No. But no, I didn't. I'm on a strict diet, as a matter of fact. Yeah. I better lay off.
I'll take that off.
honestly, when I watched the Ashtag game, I'll tell you what, they're decent, man. Mm. Like, a lot of people don't like them because of what they are and what they stand for, but players-wise.
Yeah. But even, you know, we played their Sunday side in a friendly. Even their Sunday side are decent, so.
Yeah, but they all invited me out to go, and I've spent the days with the Thames Ironworks boys, which was nice.
Oh, Poundland Pyatt was there, wasn't he?
Who?
Poundland Pyatt was there.
Yeah, Theo. Me and Theo sat there and watched the West Ham game, and most of it, you know what I mean? So, I'll see him. Bez come with us. I think Grander was there, who's left Thames Ironworks now.
Mm, skipper from last year.
It was nice to catch up with him. And I'll be back to the football when we get back, so don't worry about that. I'll be back.
You come and have it watch tomorrow?
Pushing it a bit. Out all day today. And all that, you know what I mean? But my Florida was very nice, and I picked up a nice little video which I'm going to be uploading. I did edit the whole thing, and I forgot to export it because I was going to put it up tomorrow. So hopefully I'm going to go home tonight and edit it, because there's quite a bit of editing to do. There's quite a lot of footage we got. But I went to see the Orlando. No, not the Orlando. They'll kill me for saying that. The Tampa Bay Hammers.
Oh.
I went to Tampa. We watched the Leicester game together. We spoke to them. We're starting a new series called Overland and See, where we're looking at different international supporters groups. Ghana.
One of the fan cams, we had a young Canadian lad come up to us after the Tottenham game.
Yeah.
West Ham fan.
Yeah. But that's what we want to do. We want to try and see if we can, like the days when I'm not at a football, when I was on holiday, of course, as the time goes on, we want to go and speak to these international groups, see what they're all about, how they form, why they support West Ham.
It's not for the glory.
No, obviously, because these people can't get to the London Stadium. I'm always there, week in, week out. And it's interesting to see how this group, they sort of like meet up in a bar in Tampa. I think we watched the Leicester game, which was 5:30, and it was 12:30 midday.
Yeah.
But if it's a 3 o'clock kickoff, it'd be like 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So they're all having a beer. Quite a few expats out there.
Yeah, it's midday somewhere.
One of the boys was a cousin of a boy I went to school with.
Oh,
which was, you know, small world and all that.
Yeah.
But yes, it was excellent. It was excellent to watch, and to watch it with them. Thank you for enjoying me.
Inviting me.
I very much enjoyed my day, and that video began up very soon. But let's leave it there for now, I think. Thank you very much for joining us on another edition of West Ham Fan TV's post-match pint. Me and Graham have been sitting here. I've had a quarter of a pint. I think that's all my dietitian will allow me to.
Yeah, I think you'll be all right.
Go and follow us on Twitter at West Ham Fan TV, facebook.com/West Ham Fan TV. Go and check out our website, it's still up. We're going to start adding to it soon. Go and check out the Ironworks. Graham's not with us too much anymore. He's been filling in for me while I've been away, and now the boys while they're up in Huddersfield. But he manages the Thames Ironworks. Go and check out their channel. Go and check out the Sidemates, because a lot of our boys are there. Yeah, go and check out there. That's on Bazinga's channel, if you don't subscribe already, because a lot of our fan base should be, shouldn't they? But go and check out all that out. Go and check out Ashtag at the game I went to today.
Yeah, why not? They're doing all right as well, weren't they, in the league?
Yeah, I think so. Go and check out XO, who they played today, the Sidemates. Check out everyone on the internet. You've got plenty of time. There's no time schedule. You just click on it and you can watch it as you want. Thank you very much for joining us. One thing left to say, Graham.
Come on, you on.
Come on, you on.